Began to release into my spirit that this is exactly what Brother Keith should be doing on a full-time basis. Blessing people, building people, establishing worship, hallelujah, and getting people free and delivered all over the world. This is his ministry. And I just feel like this service is going to be a testimony that God wants him released on a full-time basis to sow the spirit of worship all over this nation, all over this land. And I would like to see him start in Tulsa for a whole week straight. I don't know if that's possible. All things are possible to them that believe. How many can say amen? We really appreciate all of those that have accompanied Brother Keith, all of the musicians and singers. Y'all have outdone yourselves. Oh, you are anointed. You are anointed. And I don't know how many days y'all spent rehearsing, but it seems like to me, praise God, it was more anointed than rehearsal, right? All right, we just thank God for what he is doing. I'm not sure this is over yet. Amen. I sure would like for it to be over. Hallelujah. We've been here for a while. Some of you looking at your clock. We've been here since 3. Amen. But I remember years ago, we used to spend 3, 6, and 9 hours all night just worshiping and praising and magnifying God. So we just going to keep praising God. Y'all have anything else? You see, we can. But what the Lord spoke to me, we just appreciate all of you that have come to be a part of the service. We see a lot of our friends and former members that's working and operating in different ministries and different capacities and all over this city. And we just really appreciate all of you that have come to be a part of this great service. We have several pastors here. We see the Brother Lewis, Dr. Willie Lewis, pastor, and sister, pastor. Y'all set up. We want to recognize. We're just so happy for them. Glory. Pastors, they came out of this ministry. They all came up together with Keith, and he was a bass player and a singer, musician, and amen. It goes way, way back. And we have Sister Deborah Moore, Pastor Deborah Moore. We're going to have her to sing. Hallelujah. Great pastor and praise and worship person and prayer warrior. And she operates one of the most successful schools here in the city. And we just, I really appreciate what God has done through her life. Is Sister Judy still here? All right, Sister Judy, go on. Stand up, Sister Judy. All right, this is another pastor, her and Dwayne. We have several pastors that have come out of this ministry that's present today. We really appreciate all of you that have come to be a part of this special service. Well, the Lord spoke to me. Keith has been coming for the last few years, I guess last 10 to 15 years off and on. And he's been traveling worldwide. I know that there are many mission trips that he has been on down through the years. And we just want you don't understand that he has a ministry that's worthy of praise, worthy of support, worthy of all that we can do for him. And what the Lord spoke to me, and this is, you can judge whether it agrees with your spirit or not. The Lord spoke to me, out of all of these years he's been coming, there hasn't been a whole lot that we've done. Barely he comes in and barely gets away, barely gets out. Many times he has bought his own ticket to come. And we just want you to be led of the Spirit. I'm speaking mostly to people that know me, people that grew up under my ministry, people that know the Spirit of the Lord, people that know Keith, people that knows how much he has deposited in the lives of so many people all over this nation and world. But the Lord spoke to me, and he definitely began to deal with me about praying for Keith's release into ministry on a full-time basis. Hallelujah. And I just believe that agrees with most of you, amen, feeling and experiencing the anointing this day. But the Lord spoke to me for us to do what we could to encourage him. And I believe that this could be a major transformation in his life. And I believe that this could really inspire him to make the decision that I feel that God really wants him to make. Amen. To go into the ministry and become a full-time worker in the kingdom of God. I want to admonish as many of you that will sow into this ministry. Many times we love the worship, we love the praise, but the scripture says it's more blessed to give than it is to receive. How many with you receiving is good enough? All right, but it's more blessed to what? Give than it is to receive. The Lord laid upon my heart 10 people that could sow a seed of $100 into this ministry today. And I want you to obey the Lord. Amen. If you think little, believe little. Amen. This is not for everybody. This is for people that will obey the Spirit of the Lord, people that cherish and value his ministry, and people that have seen all down the years, through the years, how God has used him to inspire us and to motivate us and to get us moving toward, you know, if it hadn't been for this ministry, perhaps we wouldn't feel the motivation to praise and to worship like they are leading us to do today. Amen. I remember all night long, many, many, many Friday nights, we were here worshiping all night, singing in the Spirit, just like the Lord giving him song after song. This is how it started out many, many, many years ago. Many of you left this place after praying and worshiping the Lord 3 to 6 hours, and somebody had to take you home because you were under such a mighty anointing. So this ministry goes way back. It's not just what he's doing today and what he has ministered today. He was here this morning, and he was at another, Brother Willis Church, amen, also this morning as well. But it didn't start this morning and didn't end. It's not going to end this evening. This ministry goes way, way back, and he has inspired and blessed many of us. And I believe it's time for us to sow into the life of one that has been such a blessing. Amen. I'm pulling for him to come back within the next few weeks, and I believe that we can have a whole week or 3 days or something just straight praise and worship. If God leads us to do it all night. Amen. Maybe some of y'all will get saved. Get delivered, get free, get healed, get blessed. But it takes worship along with a word and prayer. It takes what? Worship. We had a great revival. Sister Deborah Moore came over, prayed us, prayed hard. We were here every night, and we were doing a 21-day consecration. And it was just really powerful. And I, and Sister Deborah, I know she wished for Keith. Amen. After all that prayer and anointing and people getting healed and blessed and delivered. Amen. And I'm sure that that was the thing that stirred her mind up and took her back many, many years ago. How God used to bless us in all of these all-night services. All right. Well, I don't know how many tickets I'll have. But I do believe I have at least 10 that would do $100. And I want you to, I mean, this is only for people that know Brother Keith, or you are motivated, you are inspired, you want to see God do a great work in his life, you want to see him traveling all over this country, you want him to return to Tulsa as soon as, we ought to have priority if we bless it right. We ought to have priority. All right, so many of you are going to feel led to sow $100 into this ministry today. I just want you to obey God. Amen. I want you to obey God. $100 is not much money anymore. Amen. Praise God. If you really want to get blessed, begin to release. The Bible says that if we sow sparingly, we will what? Reap sparingly. Amen. I believe it's a blessing to obey God. You know, it doesn't always have to be a famous evangelist. Somebody that's renowned worldwide. Amen. I know a whole lot of TV preachers come on TV asking you for $1,000. Amen. They're not coming to your house and coming to your church. And they're not going to do a whole lot for you, but other than take your money. But I believe it's good to be able to give honor where honor is due. How many can say amen? And I'm asking every person that chairs this ministry that want to see a major breakthrough, a major release into his life, I just want you to sow into this ministry. This is your opportunity to sow into his ministry. And I believe that God is going to do something mighty through his praise and worship. Amen. I know he's already doing a lot of good. I mean, he always calls me and tells me what he's doing. All the trips and mission trips and all of that. But God wants to do something even greater than what he has already experienced. I believe God can take you from glory to glory. Yes. Hallelujah. He can take you higher. Amen. And higher. I want you to respond. The ushers are there to help you to receive, amen, this blessing that you're going to sow. You're going to be blessed through this. Now, I want at least 20 of you that maybe you said $100 is kind of steep. And so you might feel that you could do 50. And if you feel led to do the 50, I believe that God will be pleased. Amen. If you could do 50, you can't do any more. Amen. But you can do 50. I believe that God is speaking to some of y'all's hearts now to plant into this ministry at least $50. Amen. Praise God. So I want you to be led of the Spirit. The Scripture says, as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. And we're so happy for our Brother England. Right on the front seat. Stand up, Brother England. Powerful evangelist, missionary, musician. And he's going to come back soon to share with us. I hope he can come back before he goes on this mission trip. Amen. So we're just so thankful for him. And I have some more denominations here. Some of you might say, I can't do 100, I can't do 50, but I can do 25. But I want everybody to do what you can. I believe that everybody should be able to sacrifice. I wouldn't dare to come to a service like this, amen, and receive all of the blessings and get inspired, get motivated, get moved and blessed, refreshed, revitalized, rejuvenated, amen, and leave taking your money with you and going up to KFC, going up to hallelujah, McDonald's, and spending $5 to $10 on junk or stuff that you really don't need. All right, I want you to prepare your offerings, and I want you to get ready to give, because I believe that this is going to be an offering that God is going to release something not only into the life of Brother Pete, but he's going to release something into the life of each and every one of you that by faith, you sow in faith and expectation that God is going to do what he said he will do. Amen. I believe it's time for us to rejoice. God loves a cheerful giver. You know, sometimes people get so sad. Y'all were worshiping the Bible girl. I mean, y'all were just really having a good time. You were really having fun. But when I got up here and started talking about the money, amen, kind of cool your anointing down, didn't it? All right. Well, Brother Keith, come back and let's see if 5 nights will get them past that point. where money will cool them off when we begin to make the appeal. All right, everybody, will everybody have an offering envelope? We trust that each one of you have an offering envelope, because we want to, we need to keep up with your names and addresses. If you would take an envelope and put your name and address on it, we will call you the next time we schedule a service like this. We will call you, we will let you know in advance so you can plan. It could be for a whole week, it could be for 3 days, it could be as the Lord leads, but we just want to get each and every one of you on our mailing list so that we will be able to contact you, amen, when this opportunity, amen, to come and to worship again in a manner like we have today for several hours. Amen. I like it when it's just, and the Lord just takes over and lead and direct. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. All right. Everybody ready? Yeah. If you're ready, say, I'm ready.
I'm ready. I'm ready.
All right. Let's all stand. Father, we thank you for your grace, your mercy. We thank you for the spirit of worship. And as we come before you, Lord, in faith, believing that what we do today will determine to a great extent some things that you will be able to do in the future. Father, we thank you for the part that we're playing in releasing this ministry nationwide, worldwide, even to a greater extent. Father, we give you praise. We give you the glory. We thank you, Lord, that we have a part in this ministry. And we are trusting you to do exceeding abundantly above all that we can think or ask. Father, we give you praise and the glory in Jesus' name. Everybody said in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen. If you would, just step out from the back to the rear. The ushers will assist you. Come and just bring your offering. All right, Brother Kenny, you going to come? You want me to do it? No, I like the way you do it. You come back up here. You come back up here, brother. We have another event that we want to share with you that will be next Friday night and Saturday night. And this is something that you do not want to miss. I was here last year when these talented students from ORU came and rendered a two-night crusade. Boy, I'm telling you, it was nothing like it. So at this time, Brother Kenny, where are you? Amen. Just come and share, and I will vouch for you after you get done.
God bless you. I just want to encourage everyone that can on next Friday, April the 8th and Saturday, April the 9th, right here at Northside Christian Center, a place for your young people, especially if you have some young people that are looking for something to do. Oftentimes, young people, they make the excuse that there's nothing to do in the house of God. So on next Friday and Saturday, right here, if you have any youth, any young people from the ages around 12, even to the college age, please come. You guys are all welcome. There will be such a magnificent display of God's power on both of those nights. Look forward to seeing you there. God bless you.
Just want to say, this will be like the cream of the crop of the talent at ORU University. You definitely, I was here last and I almost cried when I looked around and saw a lot of those people that could have been here, not here. I almost cried because it warmed my heart so much. At this time, Brother Keith. The singer's gone, I guess you're through. I guess your son, you sang them out. They wore out. I'm not sure they can hold up a lead. Okay, Brother Willie Lewis. I want you to come down and have words. That's a special request from Brother Keith. Yes, I praise the Lord. Great pastor, musician, singer, anointed man of God. Hallelujah. Brother Willie Lewis, pastor. Amen.
Bless you, Pastor. Boy, it's good to be home. Amen. We got to start right here. God bless all of you. Thank you for coming out to this great event. We had Brother Keith at our church this morning, and it was just an awesome experience. There's something that's happening in the body of Christ in the area of praise and worship. You know, we've gotten to the point where we're not having church anymore. I think it's time out for that. We need to start being the church. Amen. We need to start being the church. Amen. Instead of having an event, it needs to be a lifestyle. Oh, y'all don't want to say nothing today. But anyway, I'm just so glad to be here. Keith, God bless you, brother. We go way back, as Pastor Hill said. I used to sit right there in that corner and play the bass, and we would sing, and, you know, for years and years and years and years. And Pastor Hill always said that God had given him a vision of training ministers and sending them out. And I'm just happy that it was Sister Deborah. We're part of those that were trained and sent out. And so what you see is a vision of this great man of God. And so he deserves your support and your prayers. Amen. A lot of things that we will talk, we're still using. They were foundational. They do not change. They're principles. Amen. And I remember I was sitting on the front row one day, and Pastor Hill said, "Brother Willie is going to be a rich man." And I received every bit of that. Amen. I received that because he spoke into my life. I mean, the word was so good, I just couldn't even sit there. I sat right on the edge of the pew because I was just home every word. And I've seen the fruit of it in my life. Any of our members that came with me, that just followed me, they follow me everywhere I go. I can't go nowhere without them. Just kind of wave your hand. I mean, y'all been in church all day. All day. But when I told them we were coming here, they came too. We are so excited about Brother Keith's ministry. We believe that God is doing some awesome things in his life. We saw it when we were here. But it's because Pastor Hill spoke into our lives. And he spoke a positive word. All of my memories that I have here are awesome, good memories. Amen. They're all good memories. How many of you are members here now? You better get ready. You better get ready. What you're exposed to is going to have a profound effect on your life for all eternity. So good to see Brother England. We go way back also. Amen. Thank you for this opportunity. I hadn't planned on having words, but I know Brother Keith, and I know how he does. And so he spurred a moment productions. That's kind of the way he does. And so you have to be ready when you get around Brother Keith. Amen. But we're looking forward to having him back also. I mean, the members just went nuts over him. They just love him. Love him whenever he comes. And so we're looking forward to him coming back. How many of you all love the Lord? Yeah. No, I said, how many of you love the Lord? Yeah. Amen. Well, give Brother Keith a good God bless as he comes to the podium. We need to hear from him again. Come on. Come on, Brother Keith. I told him, don't ever come without bringing product with him again. Because we'll buy it all. We will buy it all. Amen. What's he doing? He's getting ready to play. Getting ready to sing. Amen. Thank God for the musicians. Amen. That's my axe right there. Awesome. Amen. Come on, Brother Keith.
Praise the Lord. Oh, can give me as much of those monitors. This has been a long day. Praise the Lord. As much volume as I can get. Praise the Lord. This is a song. This is what I've shared it here before. I shared it this morning, and I'm going to share it again. Praise the Lord. It's a song the Lord gave me. It's an anthem. Jesus be glorified. And that is my prayer. That is the reason I live. And I just want to say, I thank God for my wife and my family, that I can go and minister and not be hindered, you know, and I just thank God I'm able to do all those things because I have a good wife. She's my best friend in the whole world, and I love her, and I thank God for her. I thank God, maybe I should say it after I sing, because you know, every time I start talking to Pastor Sahil, I bust out crying, and I said, I'm not going to bust out crying this time. But they mean the world to me. I'm able to do what I've done, been to Europe, been to Africa, South America, Canada, throughout the United States and the Caribbean. But it's what I did passing through these walls here, laboring in prayer. It's because I came through here that I'm able to do those things and be effective in the name of Jesus. I give God the glory, and I salute you, Pastor and Sister Hill.